How many of you have felt at some point that you would have been better off doing something else? How many of you have ended up taking a job that you don't like, but it pays you well? How many of you are doing a job that neither pays you well, nor do you like it? How many of you wanted to pursue something you were passionate about, but are now stuck in a job that you hate doing? On an average, over 80% of professionals around the world today are not happy with their work. But my question is, if your job pays you well, is it okay to overlook the satisfaction you get from it? Is it okay to forget your passion and continue slogging in a job that you don't like? Here's my answer. Assuming that you spend on an average about 8 hours a day at work and work a 5 days week, that would mean spending 40 hours of your week at work. Now, assuming that you get 2 weeks of holiday every year, that would mean spending 2,000 hours of your year at work. Now, does that sound a lot? Well, let's keep going. Assuming that you spend 45 years of your life working, that would mean spending a daunting 90,000 precious hours of your life at work, which is approximately 10 years of your life. And if you're not happy with your work, guess what? You end up spending 8 hours of your day, 40 hours of your week, 2,000 hours of your year, 90,000 hours of your life in misery. Not sure if that's a great deal. What you're thinking. Following your passion doesn't pay the bills. Your calling doesn't clear the loans and mortgages. After all, those who slog it out are the ones who have better cars, better houses, better holidays, a better life. A better life? Oh well, debatable, isn't it? I completely understand and agree that you can't quit your current job because you have real needs in the real world. But at the same time, I'm also asking you whether it's fair to spend 10 years of your life in pain. I know that those of you who are watching this video are shouting, "Enough of Max, sir. Please tell us, what's the way out?" Here's my proposal. Don't take the risk of quitting your current job to follow your passion. What if the passion stuff doesn't work? Who will pay the bills? Your passion? But at the same time, don't neglect your passion and be a nervous wreck at work. Try and find the right balance. Step one. If not everything, identify some part of your current work that you may possibly develop some liking for. That will make your 40 hours a week a little less painful than now. No one has a perfect job, exactly like no one has a perfect partner in marriage. But when you identify those aspects of your spouse that you love and connect to that, the elements that you don't necessarily like in your spouse become a little easy to handle. Deal with your job the way you deal with your spouse. Focus on and highlight the positives and work through the negatives. Step two, start pursuing your passion side by side. Maybe it's very small in the beginning. Maybe it can be done only over the weekend. But when you do what you love, not only will you find deep satisfaction, but also the ability to handle what you have to do at work through the week. And you know what? Maybe one day your passion will become your profession, giving you fulfillment and the money needed to live in the real world. In other words, let's try to love the work that we have to do every day, and also have side by side the work that we love to do, even if it's just a tiny bit.